The first stage of grief is denial. So when COVID-19 first appeared, our government called it China's issue, as if, you know, a contagion was capable of being as nationalist as they asses is. And speaking of our government, we denied that our leaders were ours, as if saying hashtag not my president was enough to vaccinate us against a virus which does not make particular distinction between left or right wing or lung, as if voting no confidence in Captain Clueless makes us anything less than passengers aboard his soon-to-be-crashing Titanic, heading straight toward the ice, baby. We don't stop, collaborate, or listen. When the CDC tells us to wash our hands, protect yourself, wash your hands, show me social distancing, we look at them like they said something mystical. And when they ask us what we're doing, we say, ooh, nothing. Now see, the second phase of grief is anger. So when COVID-19 made its inevitable stateside debut, our fearless leader trumped his previous rhetoric from calling it China's issue to Chinese flu. Meanwhile, when pressured to put people above paper, he said that the solution shouldn't be worse than the problem, while readily recommending untested and questionable quasi-COVID-19 medicines with potentially deadly side effects. But hey, I guess that is one way to get over your sickness, your death. Now see, the third phase of grief is bargaining. So let's make a deal. If I tell you that two of the three most COVID-19 stricken wards in DC are in Southeast with one poorly run hospital to share between, maybe you can tell me what kind of peeps inhabit these streets. I'll give you a bet. Always bet on black. You know why six was scared of seven? 'Cause 7, 8, 9. But COVID-19 is eating ward 7 and 8 alive. Which brings me to the fourth phase. Depression. Too exhausted, too exacerbated to assume that this is a war we can win, I assume we've already lost. I assume that COVID-19 has already stricken everyone I come across. And assuming I live long enough to see anything like a vaccine, excuse me if I decline. You see, Drew done got to where he do not do flu shots because I be too Tuskegee, too trust easy. It's not that I'm anti-vax, I just know what Henrietta lacks. And I know hella well that this country will take your black magic, bottle it up, and sell it back to you as a cure that your black ass is too poor to afford. But then the fifth and final phase of grief, acceptance. Accept the fact that to our normal, we can never go back. Accept the fact that that's nothing to fear. 'Cause see, our normal is what got us here. So maybe COVID can't be cured. Maybe COVID is the cure. COVID. Capitalism only values infinite dollars. COVID, cure our violently intolerable demeanor. COVID, correct our viciously inequitable district. COVID, courageously our voices inspire defiance. COVID, change ourselves. Victory is destined. COVID, come out. Virus is dead.